Holger Patzelt. I'm the chair of entrepreneurship at the Technical University of Munich, and my research is on entrepreneurial decision making, entrepreneurial psychology, failure, entrepreneurial projects. So there's two issues that led to the motivation of the paper. One is the observation that particularly in firms that are very entrepreneurial, employees often have to move from one project to the other. So projects are often shut down pretty quickly and then the employees redeploy to other projects. And the second was our observation that in the literature, the typical view of such a project hopping is that the employee stops one project and then the next day gets into the next project. And when we talked to employees involved in projects, we found out that this is a bit of a simplistic assumption, because what happens is that both physically but also psychologically, people engage in projects even beyond the time the project is actually running, and they start engaging in new projects often when they are still on the old project. So what they're experiencing is more a transition between projects and not so much a purely sequential from project A to project B. Emotions play a substantial role in this process, because particularly when you are a lot engaged in one project and you invest all your heart blood into that project, and then the management decides to kill it and shut it down, this has of course emotional implications that you carry most likely over to the next project, because they can last for days or weeks or even months in some of the cases that we have seen. We had a multiple step approach in this project, which made it also so effortful. So the first thing was that we spoke to managers and project employees that had experienced these transitions various times in the past. And we set up more than 40 interviews with those people to understand what are important factors that make this transition process actually easier for them to cover the emotional demand that or psychological demand that may come with taking on a new project while still being involved in the prior project. And from these interviews, we got a good idea of major factors that contribute to a successful transition. These were factors like being effectively debriefed from the prior project, effectively briefed for the new project, having time to reflect on the prior project. But also what we found is that the setup of the new team played a substantial role for the employees. So they felt that if they work in an environment where the new team is perceived as competent addressing the new challenges, and they work with people they can relate to, they feel a lot better supported by their firm in the transition process than if these factors are not in place. And then finally, what we also saw is that in some firms, moving from one project to the other can be pretty chaotic, with unclear responsibilities, unclear tasks and all this. And the employees that we interviewed complained, some of them at least, that it is a substantial burden and they don't feel supported if they have these chaotic circumstances from going to the next project. From the interviews, the next step that we took is we engaged in a very formal psychological psychometrical scale development process. So we generated items, had these items reviewed by experts, and then we went all the steps that are described in the literature that you have to do to get a final set of items of a valid scale that you can use for practice. And we did find those six dimensions reflected in the items, and we came up what we call the PPTS, or Perceived Project Transition Support Scale, which allows us to measure on six different dimensions how well the employees perceive to be supported in a project transition process. We use the scale in the next step then to investigate what effect project transition support as perceived by the employees can have on the success of the subsequent project. And what we found is that the better supported the employees feel, the more they commit to their organization, which in turn had a positive effect on the performance of the subsequent project. But we also found is that if there's too much of this support, the employees, and this may be particular to this entrepreneurial project setting, the more they are supported, the less stress they feel. But if the stress is reduced too much, then in turn, this does not have a positive but rather a negative effect on the success of the subsequent project. One thing is that failure is not only measured in terms of the outcome of a project, but the learning that you take from the project also contributes to make it a failure or a success. So a real failure is only when you fail to learn and not necessarily when you fail to achieve the desired outcome. And the failure in outcome is something that I think particularly in cultures like European cultures or even more so the Asian cultures, we just need to embrace more. You know, we need to be aware that in the quickly, dynamically changing environment that business takes place today, also private life takes place today, failure is just something that is gonna happen and it's part of the learning process.